So this is a normal window in what would be a normal house. But here at Echo Pond, we have 9 foot tall floor to ceiling glass throughout the entire first floor. Echo Pond is a custom single family home somewhere outside of Boston that we are building on an 11 acre site. Today I'm gonna talk to you about the windows. We're working with Anderson Windows Lift Slide product out of Southern California, and we've used that product throughout the entire home. Lift slides are traditionally doors. These are not being used as doors, they're actually being used as windows because what we're trying to do is accomplish this floor to ceiling sight line of the pond and also the landscape. By using the lift slide, you're creating this operable window that slides in either direction. And you would think, well, I could just use it as a door. We've actually installed fixed screens. And the reason we did that was primarily because we knew that these were gonna be used as windows, but also to keep the depth of the unit down. By adding an operable screen would have increased the depth because you need to have a third track to ride that screen on. As you look across the facade here, you have a fixed unit, which is still a lift slide unit. It just does not have the lift slide function. What I mean by that, the framing is the same, the track it sits on is the same, but it doesn't operate. We also have this one right here where we have a fixed center unit, which is very similar to the fixed unit here. It sits on top of the track, but the two outside units actually slide behind it. Lift slide is essentially you're gonna grab that handle and the door sits in the closed position down low. When you spin that handle 180 degrees, the door lifts and then slides, which is why it's called a lift slide. When you're talking about truly floor to ceiling, there's a lot of precision that goes into not only the planning, but also the actual fabrication and production on site. So this home sits on a polished concrete slab. The entire first floor is all polished concrete. That our slab needed to be flat within an 1/8 inch tolerance, really, really tight tolerance. And that was because the frame of our unit for these lift slides was going to be buried and has to sit flush. So this right here where my finger is riding is essentially the track that if this unit slid would ride on it, but this unit actually sits on top of it. But it also has to be flush with the interior finish. So our interior finish being polished concrete means that there's no room to build that finished floor up or down later on. We have set the concrete and it is where it is. We needed to create this recess in the slab edge. That recess in the slab edge allows this track to sit down in a lower elevation than the rest of the slab. And then if you can see, the Anderson has these really awesome adjustable kind of perpendicular aluminum tracks that allow for complete adjustability. So when we're installing this unit, we worked with a team from A&A to do the installation, but when they're installing this, essentially an all thread and drilling and epoxying that into our concrete slab here, all the way across to set this track. Now, before we did that, we actually waterproofed and weatherproofed the entire depression in that slab edge using the Proclima Exto Seals. This is essentially a tape product that we built into the depression of the slab edge. We could have used a liquid apply, but we chose to use the tape. We're already using the self-adhered weather-resistant barrier on the house. One product, we just figured it was simple. Ultimately, you just want to create some sort of protection from any moisture making its way into the concrete slab because that is monolithic throughout the living space. The bottom track is where all of the accuracy is going to be really set. Now you're gonna install your side jams as well as your head jam. And then these units, we're gonna use a big suction cup on a kind of an all-terrain vehicle. And we're able to bring these units in and those units are gonna tilt in and they're gonna slide up into the track and then drop down and they land on the lower track there. And that's how you're gonna get that unit in. And then you're gonna do the same thing for the operable units. In the condition it's in today, all of the glass is in, everything has been tested, everything is fully secured around the window itself. Anderson has these really awesome jam jacking screws. Instead of running a bunch of shims in between the jam and the framing itself, there's actually a plastic jacking screw that moves in and out, allowing you to run a screw and make sure that this is staying plumb, but also tight against the framing. That jacking screw helps a lot. The condition that we're in now is you have this exposed aluminum track. It looks unfinished because it is. So this section here where we had that tape and now our aluminum track actually gets filled with our finished material. Now, if we were doing a wood floor, you could fill in the wood on the inside or a tile. We're gonna be filling all of this with concrete. Yes, it is going to be a cold joint on the inside. The depression and where that slab starts and stops was intentionally laid out to make sure that that cold joint would be essentially aligned with something architecturally on the inside. And we knew that when we infill this with a different concrete, there's a chance that it's going to be colored different. We've accepted that that is the end result here. If you look closely, this here is your upper track, and then this lower one is essentially the backing for, nothing rides on this, but this is the backing for where your slab is going to be poured up from an elevation standpoint. This should be your finished floor location. In between those two, there is this metal screen, and that metal screen is a drainage system. If any water sits on top of this concrete here, it's going to want to roll over to this, the two pieces of aluminum, and then be captured by the drainage track. And that drainage track will collect all the water, and it'll go to this plastic body that is an Anderson product, and then all the water comes into here and out of this tube. Anything outside of the upper track, this is a pitched sill. This here will have a hydrophobic sealer on it. Even when water is sitting on it, it will bead up and make its way into the drainage track. And whatever doesn't make its way into the drainage track will ultimately evaporate. Because we don't want that concrete getting soaking wet and getting underneath the door and into the living space. This is going to be one of the weaker points on the envelope. It will be cold out here, and you run the risk of getting cold spots on the inside. You're gonna be combating a lot of that with the door system and then the sill itself. While you have concrete that is kind of continuous, it's broken up by this aluminum, which I'm not saying aluminum is a great thermal protection, but on the outside, we end up wrapping it with wood. So you're not getting snow or ice building up on the concrete. As we get into the breezeway, you have a swing door product, a double swing door product, and then another single door. So all of our entry points to the home are all swing doors, traditional doors. And that comes up when you're talking about lift slide. How do you operate them from the outside? They're not, again, we're not using them as doors, but if you were, they're not intended to be the access point. So if they're locked from the inside or they are in the down position, you're not gonna be able to operate them from the outside. That's why we have these doors. And this is what it's all about. If you can ignore the genie lift just for a minute, beyond that, through the trees is the pond. And the house, everything around this design and the way where the house was placed in the lot was about that. So let's walk through the specific details on the inside of the home. The entire structure of these windows is actually aluminum and clad with wood on the inside. So we actually went with the Douglas fir on the inside, which will be a clear coat finish in the final condition, which will emphasize the natural material against the polished concrete slab, as well as the plastered and painted walls. So from a functionality standpoint, you can start to see how the fixed unit and the slide units interact with one another. So what you're looking at here is, this is our fixed unit. It's sitting on that track. You can see the inner track here, and then you can see that section I was talking about where this is all gonna be infilled with concrete. So this is all gonna be filled with concrete up to essentially just lower than that upper track. And then here, from here to here, this is gonna be flush with concrete that sits flush with that track. And again, if any moisture makes its way in here, it's gonna make its way to the track. And then you can see where the operable unit is. Again, you have this kind of one inch section that is gonna have a cold joint. But in terms of operable function, you have these handles. This door does not open right now. It's sitting down on the track. But when I take that handle and I push it down 180 degrees, carriage wheels actually push down out of the bottom of the lift slide, and with one finger, one strong finger, I can push open that door, and that slides right behind our fixed unit. When this door closes, we're not just relying on the weight, but these here, these are gonna be positive grabs. So when I push in that door and I drop that handle, you watch, the door's gonna get sucked against that jamb. And that essentially creates that nice tight seal against that. Now, most of the time you're gonna see the lift slide slide in this function, right? You're sliding in front of a fixed panel, but in the primary, you actually have two pocketing lift slide units. But instead of having glass here, we have an exterior wall. We have this flush hardware. You'll understand why, but you essentially do the same thing. You're gonna push it 180 degrees. I'm gonna actually fold it back in. And then when I open this door is gonna slide into the wall pocket. And that will sit all the way in. And now we have this full height floor to ceiling window. Again, lift slide door, but where it's being operated as a window, there'll be a full height screen here. So you're getting this connectivity to ultimately the nature is what they're looking for. But let me explain to you what we have going on for this pocket door, because if I stand here, we have an interior wall and then we have our exterior wall. And if you look, this is about 14 inches. And this is our 2x6 wall right in this section here. We have, again, 4 inches of exterior insulation in our cladding, but let's just pay attention to the quote unquote normal stuff. Exterior wall, stud cavity, your door is here. And if I pull this unit out, you can see half of it is stationary and half of it is the operable unit. And this operable unit sits on the inside of the wall. And in order to make it a pocketing door, you have to build this false wall here, which you can see is not connected to the slab yet because we haven't put it in. But essentially, if you look beyond that, you can see we have this 2x6 exterior wall. This is our structural wall as well as our thermal wall. And then we have a 2x8 secondary wall on the inside. And that 2x8 secondary wall is creating the pocket and the room for our 2x4 framing, which creates that pocketing or that pocket for the pocket door. I've said pocket a million times here, but let me continue to further explain. So as I shut this door, you're seeing black plywood. And that black plywood is essentially what would be typically like your drywall or plaster board. So if I were to take that off, behind that is our air seal, which is our interior vapor retarder, and then insulation. That's our 2x6 cavity with our 2x6 insulation in there, and then our air barrier is done with the vapor retarder on the inside, and then we're putting this black plywood. The reason it's black plywood is that as I'm opening the door and I look through here, I don't wanna be seeing, number one, the vapor retarder, I don't wanna be seeing the membrane, I don't wanna be seeing insulation, I also don't wanna be seeing raw wood. So the team paints it black, so as it's going in, it's a nice finished look in there. This is essentially like a patio door. You would have a fixed glass panel and a sliding unit here, and that slides in front of it. And instead of just allowing that to be a glass panel, we're building a wall around it. And by building a wall around it, we give it that pocketing function. It seems to be something that is difficult to understand when you think about an exterior door and how it would perform, but it has all of the gasketing for air sealing, and the way it functions is going to still create a nice tight air seal on this door, whether it's, you know, open, which isn't as important, but especially when it's closed, you have these multiple gasketing that essentially interlocks with each other. And as I pull it tight and I put that down, that door is going to pull itself tight. And it's gonna be locked on this side, creating that nice airtight seal, especially once we have our concrete in the bottom there. Flip back this way, we have our fixed unit here. Again, this is a lift slide unit, but it is just a stationary unit, meaning it still sits on the track. But this home only has one window. So up on the second floor, we have two bedrooms. Now, if you're paying attention, if we have two bedrooms, we probably would need more windows, but we're dealing with that with a Skylight product, but we'll talk about that in a future episode. This right here is our only window in the entire home. It is a punched opening. It sits in the second floor. It's not floor to ceiling. It doesn't sit on the floor buried in the framing or up in the ceiling. It's just a hole in the side of the wall. It is offset, so on that elevation, it actually creates a lot of visual interest, but it's not operable. And we're in a bedroom here, which requires operable units for egress. But like I said, we're dealing with that with a Skylight product, and that is a Velux product, but we'll come back to that in a future episode.